Good afternoon students, welcome back to online crash course maths class. So in the last class we have completed trigonometric functions. So in today's class I am going to start with the sequences and series. In that we are going to solve some of the NCERT exemplar problems. So the first question is, the third term of GP, that means geometric progression, is 4. The product of its 5 terms is, and the 4 options are 4 cube, 4 to the power 4, 4 to the power 5 and none of these. So let us go ahead with the solution. The third term of a GP is 4. So given A3, which is equals to 4. So what is A3 here? AR, AR square, AR cube and so on, the general form of an AP. So the third term means AR square, which is equals to 4. So this is the given thing. Now we will have to take product of its first 5 terms. The product of first five terms is AR square AR cube A into R raised to 4. We will have to find the product. So here A into A is multiplied 5 times here. It becomes A to the power 5, whereas R square. So we will have to add all the powers here. 4 plus 3 7 plus 2 9 plus 1, it is 10. So we get R raised to 10. Now this can be written as AR square whole to the power 5. AR square whole raised to 5. What is AR square now? It is 4. So we get 4 to the power 5. Check all the 4 options now. Option 3 is the correct answer. Well, the next question it is, if the sum of an AP is given by SN is equals to 3N plus 2N square, then the common difference of the AP is, and the 4 options are 3, 2, 6, 4. So we will consider SN and then we will put N is equals to 1, so that we get A1, or the first term of the AP. So here SN, which is equals to 3N plus 2N square. Now I will be going for N equal to 1 now. We get S1, which is equals to 3 into 1, it is 3 plus 2, so which is equals to 5. This is going to be A1 now. S1 means sum of first term, it will be A1. Now I will go for N equal to 2, S2 which is equals to, so put N equal to 2 in this equation, we get 3 into 2, it will be 6, plus 2 square, it will be 4, 4 into 2, it is 8, so we get 14. So but S2 which is equals to A1 plus A2, sum of first 2 terms, so what is S2 now, it is 14. This is equals to, substitute the value of A1 here. A1 it is 5. So it is 5 plus A2. Now take 5 to the left hand side, it becomes minus 5. This implies A2 it is 9. So we have got A1 and A2. With the help of this, we can find the common difference. So therefore, D which is equals to A2 minus A1. So now 9 minus A1 it is 5. 9 minus 5 it will be 4. So the common difference of the AP is going to be 4. Option 4 is the correct answer. Well, the third question it is, if 9 times the 9th term of an AP is equal to 13 times the 13th term, then 22nd term of the AP is, and the 4 options are 0, 22, 220 and 198. So let us go ahead with the given information. The given condition is, if 9 times the 9th term, 9 times A9 which is equal to 13 times A13. So now 9 times A9 means A plus 8D, this is equals to 13 times A13 means A plus 12D, then now simplify this now, 9A plus 72D, this is equals to 13A plus 13 into 12, it is 156, d. Now take these two terms to the left hand side and then simplify. We get minus 4a and then minus 84d. Minus 84d, which is equals to 0. Now divide every term by minus 4. So what do we get now? A plus 21d, this is equals to 0 by minus 4, it is 0. So we have got a plus 21d. What is this now? This is nothing but the 22nd term of the AP. This implies a22, it is 0. Check the options now. Option 1 is the correct answer. Well, the next question, it is, if x, 2y, 3z are in AP, arithmetic progression, where the distinct numbers x, y, z are in GP, then the common ratio of the geometric progression is, and the four options are 3, 1 by 3, 2, 1 by 2. So let us go ahead with the given information. So it has been given that x, 2y, 3z are in AP. Since x, 2y, 3z are in AP, this implies 2 times 2y, which is equals to x plus 3z. So this is the condition for arithmetic progression. For example, if ABC are in AP, that means A2 minus A1 should be equal to A3 minus A2. This implies B, which is equals to A plus 2B, which is equals to A plus C. So this is the condition for AP. Now ABC are in AP means 2B equal to A plus B. That's what I have done now. 2 times B, it is 2Y. This is equals to A plus C. Simplify this now. We get 4Y, which is equals to X plus 3Z. And it has also been given that x, y, z are in geometric progression. Also, x, y, z are in GP. That means this will be the first term, AR square. So now, y, which is equals to AR. What is A here? It is x. We get x into small r. Then z will be AR square, that means XR square. So I call this as equation number 1. Now substitute these two values in equation number 1. 4 times equation 1 becomes here. 4 times y, it is XR, which is equals to, now x write it as it is, plus 3 as it is. What is z here? It is XR square. So it will be XR square. Now divide every term by x so that x will be eliminated. We get 4r, which is equals to 1 plus 3r square. So now simplify this. We get 3r square minus 4r plus 1. This is equals to 0. Now this is going to be a quadratic equation. The factors are 3r minus 1 into r minus 1, which is equals to 0. So from this we get r, which is equals to 1 by 3, and from this we get r, which is equals to 1. We should not consider small r equal to 1, because it has been given that where the distinct numbers for r equal to 1, these three terms are not distinct. That is why we are not supposed to consider r equal to 1. Therefore the common ratio is 1 by 3. Check the options now. Option 2 is the correct answer. So note down this and then we'll take up the next one. Well, the next question, it is, if in an AP SN equal to QN square and SM is equals to QM square, where SR denotes the sum of R terms of the AP, then SQ equals, and the four options are Q to the power 3 by 2, second option MNQ, third option Q to the power 3, fourth option M plus N into Q square. So let us solve this. So write the given information, SN, which is equals to Q N square, and SM, which is equals to Q M square. Now we will have to find SQ. See here, SN means it is QN square, SM means QM square. So Q is constant here, Q is common. So only thing we have to replace N, or here we have to replace M. So therefore SQ which is equals to q. I'll be writing it as it is. Then in place of n or in place of m, we will have to replace q. We get q square. So overall, what do we have now? Yes, q, which is equals to q square into q, will be q to the power 3. Check the options now. So option 3 is the correct answer. Well, question number 6, it is, if an denotes the nth term of the series 2 plus 3 plus 6 plus 11 plus 18, so on, then A50 is, we have to find the 50th term of this particular series, and the four options are 49 square minus 1, 49 square, 50 square plus 1, and 49 square plus 2. So let us take up the series. It is 2 plus 3 plus 6 plus 11 plus 18 plus, so on. So now I'll be rewriting this series. So it can be written as 0 square plus 2 plus, now 3 can be written as 1 square plus 2 plus 6 can be written as 2 square plus 2 plus, so on. So this pattern continues. So the same series I have rewritten now. Now see here, this is going to be first term, second term, third term. So this will be A1, and this will be A2, and this will be A3. So now observe these terms now. If it is A1, then this has to be 1 less than this one. If it is A2, then 1 less than the number is there in the first term. Then here it is 3 and it has to be 2. So this pattern continues. So now we need the 50th term. Therefore, A50, which is equals to, so we should have 1 less than this number as a square. So 49 square plus 2 is constant. 2 is common for all the terms. So this is the required 50th term of the series. Check the options now. Option 4 is the correct answer. Well, the next question is, in a GP of even number of terms, the sum of all terms is 5 times the sum of the odd terms. Sum of all terms is 5 times the sum of the odd terms. The common ratio of the GP is, so minus 4 by 5, 1 by 5, 4 and none of these. So read this sentence now. GP of even number of terms. That means we will have to take either 2 terms, 4 terms or 6 terms. So let us take the first 2 terms of the GP. The GP is, A, AR. Then, now according to the given condition, the sum of all terms, that means we have to take this sum, A plus AR, which is equals to 5 times the sum of the odd term. So 5 times the sum of odd term. So this will be the odd term now. This is the first term. That is why this is the odd term. So it is 5A. Simplify this now. What do we get? So overall AR, which is equals to 5A minus A, will be 4A. A and A get cancels. This implies common ratio, which is equals to 4. So check the options now. Option 3 is the right answer. Well, question number 8, it is, the 10th common term between the series. They have given two series here and we will have to find the 10th common term of these two series. The series is 3 plus 7 plus 11 plus so on. And the second series, it is 1 plus 6 plus 11 plus so on. So let us consider the given two series. 3 plus 7 plus 11 plus so on, and there is another series now, 1 plus 6 plus 11 plus so on. So here common difference it is, so D1 it is 4, 7 minus 3 or 11 minus 7, and here D2, the common difference 2 will be 5. Now we have to find the 10th common term of these two series. Observe these two series. 11 is going to be common here. So this will be the first common term. First common term it is. First common term. First common term is 11. So now Now, how do you write the common difference of this series now? By starting 11, we have to write one more AP now with the help of A1, that is 11. We will have to write one more AP, and the common difference is going to be the LCM of these two differences, the LCM of D1 and D2. LCM of D1 and D2 will be LCM of 4, 5, which is equals to 20. That is here A, which is equals to 11. Starting with 11, we have to write one more AP, and D, it is 20. Common difference, it is 20, and we will have to write the 10th common term. So we need A10. This is equals to A plus 9D. So A10, which is equals to A, it is 11 plus 9 into 20. So what do we get now? A10, which is equals to, so this becomes 180 plus 11, it is 191. Check the options now. Option 1 is the right answer. Well, question number 9 it is, if the straight line AX plus BY plus C equal to 0 always passes through the 1, -2, then A, B, C are in, the four options are HP, AP, GP and none of these. So we'll take up the given equation now. The straight line AX plus BY plus C, which is equals to 0, and this line always passes through the point 1, -2 now. So X value it is 1, Y value it is -2. This implies A into 1 plus B into -2 plus C, which is equals to 0. So simplify this, we get A -2B, this is plus C, this is equals to 0. Or take this to the right hand side, we get overall 2B, which is equals to A plus C. So 2B equal to A plus C means A, B, C are in AP. Therefore, A, B, C are in AP. That is arithmetic progression. So this is the condition for A, B, C to be in arithmetic progression. Check the options now. Option 2 is the correct answer. Well, question number 10 it is, if A raised to n plus B raised to n divided by A to the power n minus 1 plus B to the power n minus 1 is the AM between A and B, then the value of n is, the four options are 0, plus 1, minus 1 and none of these. So see this, it is AM between A and B. AM means it is A plus B by 2, arithmetic mean of these two numbers. It will be A plus B by 2. So here, it has been given that this particular term is going to be the arithmetic mean of A and B. So A to the power N plus B to the power N divided by A raised to N minus 1 plus B raised to N minus 1. This is equals to A plus B by 2, because this is the arithmetic mean of the numbers A and B. Now we will have to go for the substitution method. Andra options tagondu check madbeki, cross check madbeku. N value A n tagondaga nam LHS equal to RHS bartu. That's what we have to verify. So let us take the option 1 now. Take N as 0 and check, do we get LHS equal to RHS. N 0 means we get A power 0, it is 1, B power 0, that is also 1. So 1 plus 1, it will be 2. 2 divided by A raised to minus 1 plus B raised to minus 1. That means option 1 is not the correct answer. Let us take up the option 2. So replace N by 1 now. A raised to 1 plus B raised to 1, it will be A plus B. Divided by A to the power 1 minus 1, it will be 0. A raised to 0, it is 1. Plus B raised to 0, which is again 1. So 1 plus 1, it will be 2. We get A plus B by 2. So for N equal to 1, we are getting the left hand side equal to right hand side. That means option 2 is the correct answer. Here we will have to write by verifying the options. N equal to 1 is the correct answer. So this is all about question number 10.